my channel, so today I'm gonna be showing you guys how I made this video.
Headlights past the window pane, I think of you. We're cooking love in a straight line down. If you wanna run and hide, but it makes you turn right back around. I wish you would come back, wish I never hung up.
I'm gonna be showing you guys how I doubled myself in that video, and also explain and show you guys how I did other effects in that video and all those cool things. So if you want to learn how to do that, just stay tuned. The app that I use to film my videos is the app VideoStar, and that is the app that you guys are going to need if you want to double yourself. Unfortunately, it's only available on iPhone. Sorry, all you Android users. The power pack that you guys are going to need to double yourself is called Video Layer Cake. If you want to do some of the other effects I'm doing in this video, you might have to buy different power packs, but the big one is going to be Video Layer Cake. The first thing that you do when you have VideoStar is you want to get the song that you want to make your video to. So the way you do that is you go to Musical.ly, you record the sound, and then you just save it to your camera roll as a video. Then you are going to go into VideoStar and press the plus button, and then you're going to press select song, and then you're going to press videos and go all the way to the video that you want. From here, all you guys want to do is press the little settings in the corner, and then it says countdown. That's how long you have before it starts recording to get in place. So 5 seconds is a pretty good amount. Then you want to do record speed, and you want to take that all the way down to half. That way it'll record like Musical.ly does on fast. And now this does require a different power pack, I'm pretty sure, but you can press the little button by the record button, and it says multiple or timed. You can press multiple and play the song. And then once you get to a point that you want the music to stop, you can press set. And then when it's recording, it'll stop there, so you can move to another spot and keep recording. And throughout the period of my song, I have it set up so it'll stop at certain points. Okay, here we are ready to record my first person in the shot. So since I'm going to be doubling myself, I want to make sure that I stand to one side of the camera and I'm not taking up the whole shot. Otherwise, there'll be no spot for my other half to go. Okay, so here we go. Now see, right what I did there is I went like that and my hands went into the other side. So if I was doubling myself, my hand would be cut off and it would just look weird. So I need to make sure that I stay in my lane. We're gonna try this again. I need to delete my last segment and now I'm gonna record it again. Okay, so now next scene, I'm gonna press record. That scene is how I like it. Going to go to the next scene. Now, if you guys recorded your scene and you want to watch it to make sure that you got it right, all you have to do is tap the scissors and it'll play out. If you guys messed up on a scene, all you have to do is go into the scissors, go into the clip that you don't like, and then all you have to do is press new and it'll say record new clip. So that's all you have to do. Okay, one more clip to film, and then we're going to double ourselves. Okay, there we go. So I just recorded all my scenes for just me in it, and now we're going to add the second person in it. So you want to tap the scissors. Okay, so we're going to drag it all the way to the beginning of my clip where I want to be twinned in. Okay, so now as you see, I walked into the clip. When I'm recording as the second person, I'm not going to have to step out. I'll explain that in a minute. If you guys want to be able to do how I don't step out, it is another power pack that you will have to buy. So I press new and then record new clip. Don't worry, this will not delete your last clip that you just did. Okay, so now we're going to press new or record new, and we're going to stand over to the side. Headlights past the window. is I press new, multi-layer clip, then you press back and you choose your first clip, and then front you choose your most recent clip, and then you're going to go into shape, tap the three little lines, and you're going to choose the middle rectangle. Then you want to butt it right up against you. And I need to move it just a little bit. Okay, so now we're going to press next and see. Okay, so I was over just a little too much, so I'm going to re-record that. I'm going to press cancel, record new clip, and be over just a little more. Okay, there we go. So I got my clip right here. Now, because I am working with such a small space over here and I can't move my camera really far back because of the bed, you can see that there's like a little blurriness right on the side of my shoulder. That's where the clips are joining together. Okay, so as you see how I moved over to the side, this does require another power pack. I'm not 100% sure, but when you go try to use the settings, it'll pop up what power pack to use. So what I do is I click number one, this little dial right here. So what I do is I am going to go begin, play. Oh, and then when I start going over to the side, I want to start fading out. Then by the end, I want to be completely zero. Now, I'm not going to go that much in depth about how to use this effect just because this video isn't about how to use this exact effect. If you want to learn how to do it, I can make a new, complete and different video about how to use this effect. But for now, you guys can just sort of watch what I'm doing. Okay, and I want to fade out a little quicker. Okay, so I like that. So now I'm going to press back and then create. It is kind of weird because it's all upside down. Okay. So now that we, I need to pause it. Now that we have edited the first part, we're going to move on to the second clip and record my twin for there. Okay, so for the next clip, it says I'm a crooked love and I'm standing straight, and then for a straight line down, I turn. So I need to remember to do that for my second character. So here we go. We're going to press new, record a new clip, and hopefully turn at the same point. We're going to go to new, multi-layer clip. Okay, let's see if that works. I need to be a little more over. Okay, there we go. So I'm going to click next, create. So for the next clip, I do no cloning for that clip, so I'm moving on to the next clip. And then this next clip is just like the first clip, how I move into the center. So I'm just going to record this. Okay, there we go. So, what you saw there is I went into the middle too. What I'm going to do is instead of like the last clip where I completely disappeared, I'm going to stay faded just a little bit so you can see me. I paused it when I just started to turn. What I'm going to do is I'm going to press edit, split scene, split. Okay, now this one scene turned into two scenes. So I'm going to go to the first scene, and these things on the side can just go from scene to scene. So I'm going to go to multi-layer, and I'm just going to multi-layer that small part. Oops, no. Okay, there we go. Now I'm going to create that. Okay, so now the next clip, I'm going to press multi-layer clip. Then we are going to get the two scenes. But we are going to press none. So you want to press none. And then next. Then you press number one. And then you want to just make it faded just a little bit, but enough that you can see each other and but you still know what they're doing. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna press back and create. I want to do an effect when it says window pane. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get to the part where it says window pane, or where it begins to say window pane. Oops, no, I don't want to share it. I want to split the clip. Okay. Now, after it's split, I want to split it again right after it says window pane. Okay, so now I'm going to split it again. And now that's going to leave us with a clip that just says window pane. That's all the song that's on it. So we're going to do re-effect clip. And now we want to go into the effects where you press the square or the plus sign, sorry. Now all these effects you do have to buy. Some effects are free, some are not. I'm not sure which ones are free or which ones aren't. You have to find ones that work for you. But I am going to find... So for window panes, I am going to use the 3D flip board. Now this one you do have to buy, but I'm not sure. I think you have to buy like the 3D pack or something. When you try to use it, it'll give you the option to buy the pack, I think. Okay, so now that I got to that point, I'm going to press re-effect. I want the window pane, so here we go, here it is. Okay, so now when it says straight line down, I want to put a straight line in it. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go to that clip. Okay, so when it says straight line down, I want a straight line to be there. So I'm going to split the scene right before it says straight line down. Okay. And then I'm going to, since the clip ends after down, I'm not going to worry about cutting it again. So I'm going to press new. This time I'm going to press multi-layer clip. And I'm going to, for the back, I'm going to pick that clip. And then for the front, I'm going to press text. And then I'm going to type the letter a lowercase L. Oh, whoopsie. I'm going to pick a lowercase L, and I want to pick a font that just makes it a straight line. There we go. Then we can press, I want it to be red. Then I want it to be red, so I'm going to press color. Done. Okay, next. And now when we get to this, we are just going to rotate the line right there. And then it has a little thing right here that says faded, and I'm just going to fade the line just a little bit so it's not so there. Create. So now when it says run and hide, I want the screen to get a little dark. So after it's going to say run and hide, then I'm going to press edit, split clip again. Okay, so now we are going to go to new, re-effect clip, go to the little man running, and then you want to do fade out, and you want to change it to its slowest settings, and we're going to re-effect. Okay, there we go. Okay, so here is the finished product. Headlights past the window pane, think of you.
for a crooked love in a straight line down. But you wanna run and hide, but it makes you turn right back around. I wish you would come back, wish I never hung up.
There we go. And then you just press done, exit, and then you save to your camera roll, and there you go. So guys, that is how I make my cloning videos. I know it's a little more in-depth. I just decided that I will do a little more in-depth tutorial for you guys so you know how to do a little more than just the basic cloning. So there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to subscribe and check out my Musical.ly and all my other social media. I am planning on doing more videos like this, so if you have any other video effects that you want me to show you how I do in my Musical.lys, comment down below and I might make a video showing you guys how to do it. This was my first time making a tutorial like this, and so I'm sure that I will work on getting them better, and yeah, so there we go. So I will see y'all later. Goodbye.